Hello students, this is Neha Mathur and today we will discuss about the rectifier. In my first video, I told you about the semiconductors, and in next video, as the application of the semiconductor, I discussed about the PN junction diode, its working, and today we will go with the application part of diodes, that is rectifiers. Rectifiers basically a basic electronic component or electronic device which is used to convert any AC supply into DC supply. So whatever we have, if we have any AC signal that is actually in academic levels is represented as a sine wave, where x axis is for omega t and y axis is for voltage or current. So with the help of rectifier, this type of AC signal can be converted into DC signal like this with zero frequency. Here we will have some frequency in terms of 2 pi omega, while for DC signal the frequency will be zero. So with the help of rectifier, any AC signal can be converted into DC signal. Now we have two type of rectifiers. On the basis of their designing, the categorization takes place. First type of rectifier, that is half wave rectifier, and the another type of rectifier is full wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. This rectifier basically comes under the application of diode, because whether it is half wave or full wave, both the type of rectifiers will be designed with the help of diodes, which I told you in my second lecture. Looks like this, P and L, and with the help of applied battery, this type of junction can be operated into forward bias and reverse biasing. For the proper detail of the working of the PN junction diode, you may follow second lecture, but I am just giving you the brief detail how diodes work. If the P type of diode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, while N type of terminal is connected to the negative part of the battery, then such kind of biasing is set to under forward biasing, and in forward biasing there will be proper conduction of the current, while in case of reverse biasing, the battery is just reversed, the positive terminal will connected to negative, while the negative type of the semiconductor will connected to positive. Now what will happen in this case? The junction behaves as a reverse biasing and there will be no conduction of the current. I am insisting on this topic because this concept only which will go or which will follow during the design of any type of rectifier. So you all must have clear all these thing, that how the diode is operated in reverse biasing as well as forward biasing. So firstly I will go with half wave rectifier. What is half wave rectifier, how it designs, and what will be its actual working to get DC signal from any AC signal. Half wave. Wave is so called because the applied signal looks like a wave. This is just a sine wave, a trigonometric function. Why it is said to be half? Because the rectifier which here I will go to design will rectify only the half of the portion of the applied signal. This is the only reason that it is said to be half wave rectifier. I am again repeating that any applied AC signal, the only half part of this applied signal will be rectified, while the next half or the lower half is not be treated or considered for any kind of rectification. This is the reason that such type of rectification is said to be half wave rectifier. While in full wave rectifier, the complete wave, whether it is positive half cycle or negative half cycle, the complete cycle of applied AC signal will be rectified. This is the main reason that such kind of designing comes under half wave, and the another type of designing is said to be full wave rectifier. Now, firstly, I will tell you how to design any half wave rectifier circuit, then we will go with the working of half wave rectifier. So, firstly, I will go with how half wave rectifier is designed and how it actually works. Half wave rectifier. As I told you that half wave rectifier will rectify only the half cycle of the any applied AC signal. And this half wave rectifier is designed with the help of diode. So the circuit diagram is see, I'm starting from here. This is the symbol for transformer. This is a primary winding of the transformer, and this one is secondary winding. Here I am using one diode. No need to make it in circle, just write D, that is diode, and here one resistor, that is load resistor, is used just to take the output in terms of voltage or current across here. This is the general diagram for any half wave rectifier in which one diode is used. This is the anode terminal of the diode, or I can say the P type of the diode, and this one is N type terminal of the diode. Here the diode is connected, the N type of the terminal of diode is connected with resistor, and the P type of the terminal of the diode is connected with the secondary winding of the transformer. This one is the secondary winding, and the P type is connected to secondary winding of the transformer. This is the general structure, or if you want to explain the general structure, you can say that one diode is used, or the diode is connected in series with the secondary winding of the transformer and in series with resistor at load terminal, and the N type is connected with load terminal. Now I will go, this is the general structure, and now I will go with the working. How it actually works. I am writing T. T is for transformer. See, look. Now, since what rectifier will do, rectifier will convert applied AC signal, that is alternating current. So that particular current is denoted here, because that current is applied at the primary winding of the transformer. Here I am using omega t for the representation of this axis or voltage here, just to represent the amplitude of this wave. And this, I can say that this wave is input voltage waveform. This is the AC signal. Now what will happen? See, that particular AC signal, I can say that, just to understand the working of this graph, I can say that this wave is splitted into two part. First part is said to be positive half cycle, and the other is said to be negative half cycle. It will be better for all of us if we'll go, or we will take the separate part of the positive half cycle and negative half cycle, just to understand the working of the transistor, the working of the rectifier. Now what will happen? as I am talking about the first case in which I am taking only the positive half cycle of applied AC signal, that is this part only, positive part. So as this particular part is applied to transformer, this part is, as it is transferred by stepping down the voltage at secondary winding, then this upper end of the secondary winding is treated as positive, while the lower end of this secondary winding will be negative because of the positive half cycle. Positive. The upper end will be positive while the lower end will be negative. Now, see, the P-type of the diode is connected to positive while N-type of the diode is connected to negative. And I told you that when P portion or P type is connected to positive and N type is connected to negative, such kind of biasing comes under forward biasing. So I can say that for upper positive half cycle, in this case that diode is treated as forward biasing, and in forward biasing proper conduction of current takes place. Proper conduction will happen for positive half cycle of any transformer. So that particular conduction, the current will flow, and that can be calculated or observed at the output terminal of the circuit. So the output will look like this. Here I am drawing for output. Output will look like this. This is for positive half cycle, for this part only. Now we will go with case 2, that is for negative half cycle. Negative half means this part, that is this part of the applied signal. See, now what will happen? The upper end of the secondary winding will be negative while the lower end of the secondary winding will be positive, just because of the negative half cycle. Now the P type of the diode is connected to negative part while the N terminal is connected to positive part, and such kind of biasing comes under reverse biasing. And in reverse biasing of diode, no conduction takes place, no conduction of current. So what will be the output waveform for this particular input? There will be no input. There will be no output waveform for this section of the input, because diode will not conduct, and when diode will not conduct, that diode can be treated as open circuit. I am again telling you that the complete detail of the diode, how diode works and what will be the proper biasing of the diode, can be you can follow my second lecture, in which I told you that for the reverse biasing mode, the diode will, there will be no conduction, and in case it can be treated as open circuit. So there will be no conduction and no output can be observed here. So as I told you that half wave rectifier, there will be the rectifying output for the half wave only. I am again drawing here. This is the applied AC signal. When this signal is applied at half wave rectifier, you will get output look like this. For first half positive half cycle, you will get the output, because for the positive half cycle the diode will be in forward biasing and the proper conduction takes place, so you will get the output here. While for negative half cycle, this terminal will be negative and that terminal will be positive. In this case, this diode is reverse biasing and there will be no output. So there will be no output for this particular cycle. Now again, for this positive half cycle, there will be output, and for lower half cycle, there will be no output. So this is the rectified output waveform. And only the half of the complete cycle is rectified. This is the only reason that such type of rectifier is said to be half wave rectifier. Now I will go with full wave rectifier, in which the complete cycle of the applied AC signal can be rectified with the help of designed circuit. Full wave rectifier is categorized into two parts. The working will be same, the concept will be same, only the difference is for their designing perspective. Now we will go with full wave rectifier, in which the complete cycle, that is positive portion as well as negative part of the applied signal, will be rectified. Full wave. And this rectifier itself divided into two parts. First one is center tap full wave rectifier. And another one is bridge type full wave rectifier. Both type of the circuit will rectify the complete cycle of the applied AC signal, only the difference is on the basis of their designing perspective. So firstly I will go with the designing as well as working of center tap full wave rectifier. Then we will discuss about bridge type full wave rectifier. Center tap full wave rectifier. What will be the circuit? See, the transformer is used with primary winding and with the secondary winding represented as S for secondary winding and P for primary winding. Here instead of using two diodes, we will go with two diodes. This is the again load section. From here we get the output voltage. And see, the secondary winding of the transformer is tapped from the center. This is the reason that it is said to be center tap full wave rectifier, because the secondary winding is tapped from the center just to break the applied main AC signal into two portions to provide individual supply to both the transistors, to both the diodes. I am writing D1 for first diode and D2 for second diode. This is the general structure. Just to explain the structure, you can say two diodes are used here. The first diode is connected to load terminal, while second is also connected to load terminal. The P part of the first diode is connected to the secondary winding. Similarly, the P type of second diode is also connected to the secondary winding of the transformer. And the main AC signal, the main input for which we want to go for the rectification, is applied at the primary winding of the transformer. I am marking here, I am drawing here actually. This is the main AC signal voltage. Okay. This particular signal is applied from here. Now again, just to understand the working, I will go with two cases, case 1 and case 2. Case 1 is for positive half cycle, that is this part of the applied signal, while the case 2 is for negative half cycle, that is for that part. Okay.
So now what will happen for the positive half cycle? This particular charges is transferred here, and this terminal will be positive, this will be negative. Now the center of this secondary winding is actually splits the charges, and that particular center is treated as individual terminal of the circuit. So this is the positive because of the applied positive signal, and this will be the negative terminal. Now again, from lower section of the circuit, that terminal will be positive. And this is negative as from the previous applied input. Thus, what will happen? See, here for this section, the separate individual voltage is applied for this diode, while for this diode, the separate voltage is applied from here. Now, as for the positive half cycle, this terminal is positive, which is connected to diode from here, and the p-type of the diode is connected to positive, then D1 diode will be forward biased. I am again repeating, the p-type of the diode is connected to the positive terminal of the circuit, and then D1 will be forward biased, while the p-type of the D2 diode is connected to negative section, and D2 will be reverse biased. For the positive half cycle, only one diode will start to conduct the current just because of the forward biasing, while in this case the lower diode, that is D2 diode, will be reverse bias, and in reverse bias there will be no conduction and current will flow across D1 diode, and this can be observed here only just because of D1. This is the case for positive half cycle. It will be more clear for you if I will explain for negative half cycle also. Now see, for negative half cycle, I will have to replace here from negative and this for positive, and same charges is transferred here and here. Now what the center will do, center will split the charge into positive and negative. Now D1 diode, the p-type of the diode is connected to negative terminal, and it makes diode D1 reverse bias, while the p-type of D2 diode is connected to positive terminal, and it makes D2 to work into forward biasing. Now just opposite to the case 1, the diode D2 will start to conduct proper conduction, and D1, because of the reverse biasing, there will be no conduction of current. So now D2 will start to conduct and there will be current. I am marking it this from I2, and for first case I am marking current I1. So the total current, that is I, which is nothing but I1 plus I2. I1 is from case 1 and I2 is from case 2. So the complete current for both the cases can be viewed here, and the actual output waveform will look like this. Why the complete rectified output? The first section is for positive half cycle, because for positive half cycle D1 starts to conduct and there will be current look like this. And for second half cycle, the diode D2 will be in forward biasing and there will be conduction, and it can observed from here. So for both type of cycle, whether it is positive or negative, whether it is positive or negative, at least one out of two diodes will be conduct, and that particular conduction in terms of a drop voltage can be observed from here. So the complete applied input signal will rectify it in terms of full wave rectification like this. This is the reason that such type of circuitry is said to be full wave rectifier. Now the next type of full wave rectifier is bridge type full wave rectifier. Again, the working mechanism will be same, only the difference on the basis of the designing of bridge type full wave rectifier. Bridge type full wave rectifier will use 4 diodes for the designing of its complete circuitry. In half wave rectifier, we use only one diode, while with center tape full wave rectifier, we use 2 diodes. And for next bridge type rectifier, we use 4 diodes. Bridge type. Why this is called bridge type? because its circuit mechanism is based on Wheatstone bridge, which actually looks like bridge, Wheatstone bridge. And full wave again, because it again rectify the complete applied AC signal into this. That's why it is called full wave. Now, what will be the circuit for such type of rectifier and how it actually works? For that, I am drawing the circuit diagram. Again, the transformer with its primary and secondary winding. Here, four diodes are used. First, here to get the output, I am again using load resistor. Now I will mark the name for specific diodes. This is diode D1, this is D2, this is D3, and this will be D4. It actually looks like bridge. Here four terminals. I am marking A, B, C and D. Okay, this is the general structure for bridge type full wave rectifier. For the explanation of such type of circuitry, you can say that four diodes are connected in such a manner to make the complete structure of bridge type full wave rectifier and the transformer with primary as well as secondary winding is representing here. Now, the working part of this circuit. Again, with the help of cases, two cases, I will explain it, I will elaborate it. First case for positive half cycle and second case is for negative half cycle. Before start this, I will mark the actual input waveform for which we want to go for rectification. The input waveform looks like this. AC waveform with x-axis represented by omega t and y-axis in terms of voltage. Okay, this is the input, and after the rectification, since this is a full wave rectifier, we will get like this. Now, how from here to here, this can be understood with the help of these two cases. Firstly, I am going with case 1 for positive half cycle. So, for the positive half cycle, the upper end of the secondary winding is positive while the lower end is negative. Now, we will have to check out of 4, how many diodes are connected for forward biasing and how many is working for reverse biasing. Now, starts from D1, the P-type of the D1 is connected to the positive terminal. So, it is clear that D1 is always forward biased. Now, come with D4, the negative, that means N-type of the diode is connected to positive terminal of the battery. So, I can say that D4 will be reverse biased. Because the N-type is connected to positive opposite biasing, and for opposite biasing, I can say it will be reverse biasing. Now, go with D3. D3, the N-type of the diode is connected to the negative terminal of the secondary winding, which makes it to work for reverse biasing, for forward biasing, because the N-type of the diode is connected to negative, and in this case diode is for forward biasing. Now come with D2, I marked it here wrong, it will be like this. D2 is represented like this. I am correcting it. Please correct. Now, see, the P-type of the diode is connected to negative section. Positive is connected to negative and it makes D2 to work for reverse biasing. Hope it is clear that positive is connected to positive, D1 will be forward bias. Negative is connected to positive, D4 is reverse biased, while D2, the P-type is connected to negative, it makes D2 to work for reverse biasing, while the N-type of the D3 is connected to negative, negative is connected to negative, and it makes to work D3 into forward biasing. Now, out of 4, D1 and D3 is for forward biasing, while D2 and D4 is capable to work for reverse biasing. So, what will happen for the positive half cycle of the applied signal? D1 and D3, because of forward biasing, starts to conduct and behave like closed circuit, while D2 and D4, because of reverse biasing, there will be no conduction and behaves like open switch. So, the current starts to flow from here to here like this, from here, I am marking it from arrow. So, the current will come from A to B branch, and this can be observed across RL. Again, it will end from here to here like this, from D3 also. Starts from here and it ends from D3. So, both the diodes will conduct, and the proper circuit, and by the making of the proper circuitry, the current will flow for the positive half cycle of the applied signal, and it will look like this. Now come with the second case, that is for negative half cycle. I am erasing from upper section. For negative half cycle, what will happen? Case 2, that is for negative half cycle. See, for negative, this terminal will be negative, this will be positive. Same charges is transferred at the secondary winding. This will be negative, that will be positive. Now the same task, out of 4, how many diodes will be forward biased and how many will go with reverse bias? Now again start with from D1. See, the P-type of D1 is connected to negative, and it makes diode D1 to work in reverse biasing because the P-type is connected to negative. Now go with D4. The negative terminal N-type of the diode is connected to negative. Negative to negative, which makes diode D4 to work in forward biasing. Now come with D2. The positive P-type of the diode is connected to positive. It makes positive to positive, that is forward biasing, and D3. The negative type, that is N type, is connected to positive. So, D3 is for reverse biasing. Again, with like case 1, 2 diodes is working for forward biasing and 2 for reverse biasing. Same for the second case, D1 and D3 is working for reverse biasing, while D2 and D4 is for forward biasing. So, for the forward biasing, there will be conduction, and diode behave as a closed switch, while for D1 and D3, because of reverse biasing, there will be no conduction and diodes behave like open switch. Now come to the circuit diagram. As D4 and D2 is conducting, D2, that is this. Now what will happen? Current starts to flow from here to here like this. It will come from here, follow the path, that is C to B, comes across load terminal and back at D4 terminal. So a proper path can be marked, starts from positive, from C to B across RL, and it will end from D to A. So again, there will be proper path for the conduction of the current for second case also. So for this applied AC signal, again there will be rectified output. I can marking it here. Now again, for positive half cycle, output will be like this. For this negative half cycle, output will like this. Thus, I can say that full wave rectifier, whether it is bridge type or center type, is capable or responsible for the rectification of the complete applied any AC signal. Only the difference is on the basis of their designing. Instead of using two diodes, here we will go with four diodes, while in center taping rectification, there was only two diode, and in half wave rectifier, we used only one diode. And the individual circuitry as well as their working, I explained. I hope it is clear with all of you. Kindly review the second lecture also, which makes your concept more and more clear related to diodes, and then you will be more comfortable to understand the actual working of the rectifier. So I hope you are following this. Students, one more thing I am considering here, that is, I am drawing here. See, that was the input waveform. Whether if you are using half wave rectifier, you will get the output like this, 0, this, 0. While with full wave rectifier, center tape or bridge, you will get output like this. And what I am trying to say, that this type of output or this type of output providing us rectified output, which is not in pure DC form, such wave is said to be pulsating DC, pulsating, or I can mark impure DC. That is in DC form, that is a direct current, that is also is treated as direct current, but not in pure in nature. And to get the pure DC, which looks like this, with frequency 0, we will have to go with one more device, that is filters. So as the output of half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier is applied at filters, then we will get pure DC. And this topic, that is filters, I will discuss in future. But for today, you must have the basic idea how rectifiers work, what is the circuit diagram, and what will be the output. But for your knowledge, you must have clear about this, that the output is not pure DC. For the pure DC, we will go with filters also. So the rectifier is clear with all of you, and in next video, we will go with the another application of the semiconductors, that is transistor. In next video, I will go with the transistor, and for the semiconductor, the complete detail of the semiconductor, complete detail of the diode, you may get link from here and from the description also. I hope the content is beneficial for all of you, and if you are following the content, then please consider to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so that you can get notified from updated videos. And for the next lecture, next video, we will go with the transistor. Thank you so much.